Good morning, second graders. It's Miss Caffone. We're working on our second grade sketchbook. We are going to be doing pages number 9, which are just for fun, draw more tools. So I would go into Google and I would search up pictures of actual tools, or I would find tools that were in my house and I would look at them and draw from them. Drawing from observation, which means drawing from looking at things, is probably the best way for you to get things to look more realistic and for you to get good detail in your artwork. So that's what I would recommend for that. And then we're going to be doing page number 10, which says, knowing my shapes, how many circles, how many triangles. So you can color it however you like. If you want to come up with some type of color theme, like maybe you want to use all primary colors or all secondary colors, or all warm colors or all cool colors, whatever it is that you'd like, color them in. And then see if you can figure out how many shapes that they're asking for you in the directions above. That's it. Directions are pretty easy for this week. Okay, so here's my Just for Fun, Draw More Tools, page number 9. I went onto my computer. I typed in drawings of tools. That is the key word. Put drawings in, because then you'll get actual like line pictures of the tools. If you just type in tools, you might just get photographs, and it's a little bit harder to figure out like what lines that you want to use. You can go ahead and challenge yourself if you just want to type in tools, or you can type in a specific tool like hammer. So here's all different line drawings of tools. Depending on your ability level, maybe you might want to stick with something that's a little bit more simple, like these. If you like to be a little bit more complicated. So look at the hammer in this picture, and then let's look at the hammer down here. See how this one has a little bit more detail, has some shading on it, and it's at a different angle where it looks more three-dimensional. So it's up to you how challenging that you want to make the lesson for yourself. Now that I have all of my tools drawn, I'm going to outline everything in a black colored pencil. I'm going to press pretty hard. I kind of want it to look like a Sharpie marker without it bleeding through onto my next page.
On my dreams, there's nothing to do but believe. Just believe.
Fixed anything that was crooked. This thing was very crooked, the screwdriver that I did. Still in the middle of erasing it a little bit. So I just fixed that as I did my outlining. That's why outlining is very important. It helps you kind of like look at your whole drawing and decide if something needs to change or be edited before you start going into the coloring part. So now I'm gonna add some color. I'm using some of my Prismacolor colored pencils and check back in a little bit just to see what I do. Okay, so my Just for Fun page is finished. I added some color to my tools and I added some shading in areas where there would be like a shadow to make my tools look a little bit more three-dimensional to try to challenge myself. So that's it. That's a pretty simple page. I probably would color the background a little bit. I think it'll make the tools pop a little bit more. All right, I added a little bit of background color to my page to kind of give it a little bit more of a finished look. And now I'm gonna start working on page number 10, knowing my shapes. All right, so I'm trying to choose a color theme for my knowing my shapes page. So I typed into Google color themes, and then I saw a couple of suggestions for color theme ideas, and there was one that said summer, so I clicked it. And then these are some of the ideas for summer themed colors. Summer is my favorite season, so I figured why not use that as my inspiration for the colors that I'm gonna pick. I really love this color theme. It kind of reminds me of like the Caribbean, because like this looks like the water in the Caribbean, some sand or some sun. So I'm gonna try this. I like how it has some cool colors and it has some warm colors. So I'm gonna use those as my inspiration. Okay, my second graders, I can't wait to see how many circles and triangles that you're able to count for this page. I know the answer. Let me know what your guesses are. See you next week. Bye. Hey, chicken. Are you too sleepy to do art today? No.
Half of your face looks annoyed and half of it looks like you're happy. Me too sleepy to do art again.
Well, it looks like all of my helper cats are not helping me this week. Maybe next week they'll be more lively.